Hi guys, and welcome to this Bootstrap 4 video. This is Jamie from System22 and webdesignandtechtips.com. Well, this video is going to show you how to make sure that your Bootstrap sites are cross-browser compatible. That means they display correctly on Explorer, Chrome, Firefox, whatever browsers you may be or your customers may be watching on. And it's a really important step, and it's not too difficult to do. So this video is an excerpt from our course on how to build a coming soon page. It's a comprehensive course that will show you how to build a coming soon page from scratch using HTML and CSS3. We use JavaScript to actually for the countdown itself, and we use some PHP script for the subscribe and contact forms. Now this site, as you can see here, it's just got a countdown timer and it's got some nice hover effects going on. We've got a working contact form here, and we put all this together from scratch, and we've also got a working subscribe form here. And like I say, this course shows you how to do that, put this whole site together, and of course you can use it for any sort of website you want. But if you're interested, have a look. You can get the course for just $10 from a link below, which is a huge discount for our YouTube subscribers. Anyway, have a look at this video and learn how to make your Bootstrap 4 site cross-browser compatible. I think now that we've got our emails working and our subscribe and contact forms working, let's just check that this is going to work in different browsers. So let's go to our folder. And let's open with Firefox. Firefox is opened in a different monitor over here. Yep, that seems to work okay. All our effects and gradients are working fine there. Good, so we're happy with that. Let's try opening it with Explorer. Oh, I immediately see a problem there. Okay, it's blocking the JavaScript. Unblock that, that's fine. Okay, well, our gradients are obviously not working here. This is Internet Explorer version 11, I think. 11, yeah. Explorer's pretty much retired now. Of course, with Windows 10, they've got the new Edge. There are always some compatibility issues. We can fix this if we do an RGB gradient instead of a hex one like we've got going on here. So let's go to a site called CSS Gradient Generator. I'll put this in your resources as well. Let's see, there's something close to what we want, but we want it the other way around. So let's switch these colors around. There we go, now we've got the transparent at the top and the black at the bottom. And the black, we want to be plenty black, so let's take the opacity to about there. I think we want to roll it up maybe a little bit higher, something like that. Something like that. Play with it until you've got it what you want. And it's generated this code for us right here, which is fantastic. Once you're happy with it, let's copy this and we'll replace what we've got in our CSS with this code. And it'll make it compatible with all the browsers. Chrome, Explorer, Firefox, Opera, Safari. So We don't need that first little bit. That's just a comment. You can copy if you want. It won't hurt, but I'm not going to bother. I'm going to take it from there all the way down. That's a comment too, but we'll keep that in there. Control C to copy. Let's go to our CSS file. Great, we've got it open here. And that was our BG dark background for the nav bar, wasn't it? There it is right there. So let's comment this out. Oops. And so it won't be red. I mean, you can delete it if you want to, but let's just tighten these up, get them in line here. Okay. And one thing we're going to want to do, because if I do that now, save it and open it with Explorer, it's still not going to work. And I'll tell you why in just a second. I'm sure some of you may have guessed. Now let's save. Let's go to Explorer. And refresh this here. And it's kind of worked. It's kind of worked. Actually, we've got our gradient there, but the original background is still showing through that gray. So what we've got to do, like I say, I'm sure if you've been following along, you know, we've got to force it. Let's just copy this important right here. Paste it just in front of that little semicolon there. Control S to save. Let's go back to Explorer and refresh again. There we go. Now that gradient's worked. Fantastic. Just what we want. Of course, the other thing is we haven't got our little opaque background behind our text here, which actually you can read that fairly well, but I'd like to be able to read it better. And if you had a different image behind there, you know, like a lighter image, it would be pretty much impossible to read it. So let's just make sure this is working. Yeah, it's working on all of them. Let's fix this. So if we go back to our CSS here, that is, it was, I think it was called TXT. There it is. There's the background. We've got this hexadecimal number in here, which seems to work fine on Firefox and Chrome. But Explorer, like I say, poor old Explorer, it's lagging behind a bit. We're going to have to change that to an RGBA color, which is fine. I happen to know, I think that's going to be like 000, probably 6 or something like that on there, I'm guessing. But just to make it easier, let's copy this, or let's copy the first 6. We don't even need to copy, it's all zeros, you know. I can probably just about remember that. And we'll go to another site called Hex to RGBA. And this will convert our hex. There, we've got 0, that's black right there. So we've got 000. You can put in that, whatever it was, 06 or 08, and it'll tell you it's an invalid code, probably. Yeah, because that's the actual opacity. So if we leave it to black, which is 6 zeros. Of course, we only use 3 in CSS3. And you can take the opacity down to the level you want. Actually, about where it was probably good. There's no live demo here, but so you kind of got a guess. But if we look, let's bring our site up in Chrome again. So here we are in Chrome. Just inspect this. And it's text right there, text. There's the color. This may affect my mouse cursor after I've done this, I apologize. So we're at about, yeah, at about 60% there, probably 55-60%. See, it's sort of, there'd be 50%. So we're just guessing that it's there. So when I stop recording this, my cursor may have a little thing on there until I start recording again with something else. I apologize, but I'm sure you'll be able to see okay. So let's go back to that website. And let's take it down to sort of 60% where it was. Hit that. And it generates that code. Yeah, 0.6. Copy that. Control C. Back to the site. Actually, we want to go to Explorer, don't we? No, we don't. We want to go to our CSS. Don't know what I'm talking about here. And we want to change this to the RGBA color. There we go. Save that. Control S. And back to Explorer this time. Refresh. There we go. We've now got that opaque background back in there. And our linear gradient. So that's making it cross browser compatible, which is really important if you want to, you know, do it properly. You want to make sure that it works on all browsers. So that should be fine now. Well, there you have it. I hope that was useful to you. If you enjoyed the video, please like, share, and subscribe to our channel. If you're interested in web development, this course and many other courses you'll find below. We've got some huge discounts for all our YouTube subscribers. There's also some great free courses down there, so do take a look. Once again, this has been Jamie from System22 and webdesignandtechtips.com. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.